saying, it's a very right-wing format, which we are trying to achieve here with the support of all you guys. We branch out into specializing in crypto trading, and then branch out the other side of the blockchain development. And with the people that we have here today, potentially, and we grow in size, we'll have more people who are into something special like fintech, and we'll dig deep into that as well. I'll tell you a bit about Alluma. We are going to launch an exchange very soon in India, and it's a crypto exchange. It's going to have a high number of crypto pairs, and we're coming with a very deep order book with very high liquidity partnerships. And this meetup today, we're going to be focusing on what's happening around the regularity framework as well, which is going to be addressed by Anirudh, and Sheenam from Kryptomoney is going to shed some light on that as well. Aakash will be, we have Aakash here, who's an expert on crypto trading. He's also the founder and CEO of Alluma. He's going to be talking about crypto to crypto, which a lot of people that are into the virtual currencies and have been there for a couple of years might be familiar with what is crypto to crypto. But a lot of people have been into fiat crypto till now, which is you have your base currency, which is INR if you're in India, and you can buy the virtual assets and also trade with them and then withdraw it back to your base currency. Things are changing. We all know what's happening in India, and we're sure that the regulators and the drafting committee will come up with a great solution towards it. We are happy to support them. We welcome regulation because that's going to construct the ecosystem for a better future. That's all we want. We don't want scams to be happening. That's also the agenda of the whole meetup, not today, but even going forward. If we create a closed group, a well-knit community, so that if someone has an offer for buying, let's say, ATC or MTC and things like that, which we have seen in the past, they don't just pounce upon it because they're going to 10x their money. So we'll try to create an environment so that everyone who's already there, who's been here for, there are people I see who've been in crypto for 5+ years. I myself have been in crypto for 6-7 years now. So I think we all need guidance. We all need an environment where we can all grow together and feel safe at the same time while doing it. And that's what our intent is, and what we're going to talk about. We have Sheenam with us. Unfortunately, Rohit Pagreja from Kryptomoney wasn't able to make it back to Delhi from his Aman Sanduja Yatra. He's stuck there still, and he's going to be with us in the next one, probably. Sheenam's going to be talking about what's happening in India. They're a news and blog website. They're going to share some information on life, on what's happening at the moment in different scenarios of framework and advertising and everything. So, anyway. Anything else to introduce you?
Thank you, Anirudh. Hi, guys. I'm Sheenam. I'm the head of content at Kryptomoney. And today we have blockchain enthusiasts. We have banker. But actually, I'm a scientist. And I would be actually leaving for my PhD in New York very soon in the coming few weeks. But the concept of cryptocurrency and blockchain was very intriguing. It got me digging deeper, and I soon realized that this is one concept that is a little away from what I do. But I think if I culminate over time, if I put my energy on it, maybe I can work on it in the future. So, like Abhimanyu stated, I'm here to enlighten you about what's been happening, around the country, especially the countries in Asia and moreover in India, how cryptocurrency regulations are shaping, what we do and what we are going to do in the cryptocurrency market. So, to start with, I think everybody knows about the ban that RBI put. Around April, RBI had actually deauthorized all the banks to put a stop on cryptocurrency transactions, and they had given them a 3-month deadline, which was actually, many people saw it as a big blow to the market. Many cryptocurrency exchanges saw it as a big blow, and they thought that, the only way they are going to survive is to move overseas to countries where these things are entertained, like Malta or like Singapore, Hong Kong, which is now the hub of ICOs. So, but, actually there is a bit of good news coming. And we have actually the Secretary of Department of Economic Affairs at Ministry of Finance, Mr. Subhash Chandra Garg, today. He actually disclosed that in the first week of July, they would be actually setting up a legal regulatory framework for cryptocurrencies, and which actually would be in the best interest for people investing in cryptocurrencies in India. So I guess that is a good move. I think people are much in the favor of getting the cryptocurrencies regulated rather than getting them banned. And there was actually a very interesting survey actually, which also was up on our website, Kryptomoney, where it was actually revealed that Indian women are actually more keen in investing in cryptocurrencies, more than Indian men are. So this shows that it's not just, it's a very uniform investment. It's not something that is coming only from one side of the gender or anything like that. So that is another thing. And I don't know if how many of you know that Facebook had actually banned the cryptocurrency ads. So yeah, I think Facebook is a platform where I think everybody is. And I feel that advertisements actually play a major role in how they govern a lot in what you invest in, what you do not. But most of the, this was actually right after Bitcoin had achieved a peak of around $20,000 in December. And, there were a lot of speculative issues and people were actually doubting, why. So Facebook and then Google followed, Twitter followed, and there were bans around it. But just a couple of days back, Facebook is now lifting the cryptocurrency, the ban on the cryptocurrency ads. But it's provisional. Provisional as in you have to authorize, you have to authenticate yourselves on the platforms. And I think this is very good because the people who are actually running Ponzi schemes or Ponzi ads, they would be kept aloof from it. So in that way, it's good. Talking about Thailand, I think Thailand has been very good on that front because they do keep regulating cryptocurrencies. And it was only a week back or 10 days back when they actually legalized 7 cryptocurrencies and they put regulations. And the 7 cryptocurrencies are the ones that people invest the most in, like Bitcoin, Ethereum as we know, Bitcoin Cash, Ethereum Classic, like Litecoin, Ripple and Stellar. So, and actually the reason for them choosing these 7 cryptocurrencies